Hello traders, welcome back to a new Sierra chart tutorial video. I haven't done one of these in a while and just thought I would bring up a little quick technique, or not technique, but a process that I use in order to save all my default indicator or study settings on my charts. And that way I have all my settings saved and I can just quickly apply them to any new chart that I want without having to manually go over and start adding all the indicators again. Okay, so before we dive right in, as always, make sure to subscribe, hit the thumbs up. That greatly helps the channel to keep growing and bringing you more content like this. So let's start off first. As we know in Sierra chart, what we call normally indicators are called studies here, and you can find them by either right clicking and selecting studies, or you can go to the top menu bar and click on analysis. That's going to bring up a menu, and then you're going to click on studies and you're going to get the same window. For this example, you know, I'm going to try to keep it very basic, just to go over the general settings. So as you can see for this chart, I only have two indicators on. One is the price line, which is going to be the horizontal line for the current price, and the other one is this vertical lines that I set as the daily open. This is the futures market, so these lines go on at 6 p.m. Eastern time every day. So let's just add a couple of more indicators, and then I'll show you how we can save all this studies as your default template, so then you can apply it to any other chart. Because remember, in Sierra, when you open up a new chart, it's going to be completely empty. There's not going to be any price line, there's not going to be any studies on. So we have the price line, we have the daily open. Let's say I want to add a countdown timer, so that way there's going to be a countdown for, in this case, I'm on a 1 hour chart. So if I click apply, you can see that now we have the default countdown timer, but now I want to edit this. So I'm going to mark it here, go to settings, let me see, display time in seconds only, no, I'm just going to leave all this here. Short name, I'm gonna put it, I'm just gonna put countdown timer. And then under subgraphs, I'm gonna change the colors and I'm gonna make the background just white and then the letters black. And let's say I wanna make this a little smaller, so I'm gonna go 15 on the font size. I click apply and there's our new timer. I click okay. I click OK, and now I'm just going to click this and I'm going to drag it over here. Okay, so now we have, if we go back to studies, now you can see that we have a countdown timer, a price line, and the daily open line. Let's say I just want to add one more thing. Let's add a clock. You know, so let's say clock real time. Click apply. And there we have our clock. So same thing, I'm gonna go to settings. And here, I'm gonna put the background again in white. I'm gonna leave the letters black. Let's say I wanna put the font size 18. And then in settings and inputs, use AM and PM, yes. And I click apply. And same thing, so now I have my clock, okay? So now we have a basic chart with four indicators on it. So let's say now I want to save all these four studies into a collection so that I can bring it up anytime I open up a new chart. Okay, so I just right click or I go to analysis studies and I have all the four studies here. Now I can either save everything as a collection, or I can individually save each one of this. As you can see, if I go down up into the Let me just bring this whole thing down. If I go up here into the analysis menu, you can see I have a ton of options here. All these things that you see under analysis, these are presets that I have already saved on my system. So that, for example, let's say I want to put in a, a weekly VWAP on this chart. I already have a template called weekly VWAP, and you'll notice many of these have a plus sign. I'm gonna go into that a little bit later on, but the plus sign means that the system is gonna ask you if you wanna erase any other indicators before applying this. So I'm gonna click on my preset for weekly VWAP, and I'm gonna get this window. I get this window because, again, there's a setting that I'm gonna show you that I selected. So if I put yes, it's gonna erase all the four indicators I have, and it's just gonna apply the VWAP. I don't want that because I wanna put the VWAP on top of everything I have. So clear existing studies, I'm gonna put no. And now it's just reloading, calculating the VWAP, and there you go. Now you can see that I have my clock, countdown, timeline, the daily lines, and a weekly VWAP. So again, if I open my studies window, you can see that now I have five studies in here because I selected one of my presets, okay? So let me teach you now how you can save these presets. Let me just get rid of the weekly VWAP. I click remove, apply, and now it disappeared. So let's say that I wanna, let me just make sure that I don't already have this save. Let's see, clock. Okay, I don't have a preset just for the countdown timer. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna go to studies and I'm gonna go and highlight countdown timer. I'm gonna put down here, I'm gonna highlight countdown timer, and then down in this part, I'm gonna give it a name. So I'm just gonna put countdown timer. And you can see here you have these options. If I just click save all, it's gonna save all four of this as one whole collection, which I'm gonna show you later. But for now, let's just save the countdown timer. So I have the name for it, and now this is very important. Remember that plus sign that I told you about? That is over here. I wanna click on this. It says prompt to remove existing studies, and see that when I put that, a plus sign comes up. That means that the system is gonna ask me if I wanna erase all the other studies that I have on the chart before it applies this new study. So now that I have this a name, I have prompt remove studies enabled, I'm gonna click save single. Now it's gonna ask me to confirm. Save select studies using name countdown timer plus, yes. And now that is saved. And so if I go now into the analysis tab, you can see right here, it says countdown timer plus. So that means I saved that setting. So let's say, let's go to studies and I'm gonna erase my countdown timer. So you can see it disappeared. It used to be there. So now let's say I go into whatever chart I want and I want to apply a countdown timer here. Now I just go into analysis, I go to countdown timer plus, I click on it, and I'm gonna get the prompt. Remember, if you don't click that box and you put a plus sign on it, this is just gonna apply the countdown timer and is gonna erase all the other indicators that I have. So I don't wanna do that. So now I say clear existing studies on chart. I'm gonna put no. And now right here, is again my countdown timer, and I can just click and I can move all this anywhere I want on the screen. But there is now my countdown timer again. If I go to studies, I got all the four of them back on the chart. Now, what if I want to save an entire collection of these four things? Let's say these four things are the basics that I want to put on any chart that I use. And this is actually what I do use. I always have these things on. I always use a clock, a price line, a daily open line, and a countdown timer. The placement of this, don't really worry about this, because if you take this off and put it in again by default, they're always going to come back around here. So you're going to have to move them around on the screen. But let's just save the whole collection. So we go to analysis, studies, and I have four indicators here. So I'm going to put new chart studies. So I know that with this collection, I'm going to get all four of these indicators applied. I'm going to click on prompt to remove existing studies, and I'm going to click save all. Now it's going to bring the confirmation, save all studies in studies to graph using name, new chart studies plus, yes. And now it's all saved. So now if I go click on analysis, now you can see I have here new chart studies as one of my options here on the analysis tab. And again, all this, I have a lot of presets. And remember, all these presets are saved in your system by default at Sierra Chart-Data. So on your hard drive, this is going to be saved by default right over here at Sierra Chart/Data on your hard drive, or wherever you selected by default is going to go there. So you can go into your hard drive with your Finder and just erase any, you can just go and erase any of this presets if you don't use them and you want to clean this up. You just go to the data folder and they're going to be under the category of study collections. Okay, so just to finish up, let's go to studies and I'm just going to erase everything I have on this chart. Okay, so now this chart, you can see it's completely blank. There's no price line, there's no countdown timer, there's no clock. So let's go and apply my study collection that we just saved. I go to analysis. I go to new chart studies plus, click on it. It's going to prompt me clear studies. Well, right now the chart is empty, so it doesn't really matter, but let's just hit no. And right there, I have now everything back up again. And if I right click studies, you can see all my defaults that I saved are not here. I have my clock, my current price line, my daily open lines, and my countdown timer. Okay, so that's pretty much it for the video. Hope this has been helpful. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. But again, this is how you can save either a single study setting or a whole collection of indicators or studies. So that way, when you have new charts on, you can just say, click on a preset and it's going to save you a ton of time every time you want to apply different things, and you already have them all customized the way you like them. Okay. Thank you all for watching. Hope you had a great day, and I will see you all in the next one. Take care.